Hello friends, so today in this video we are gonna derive the formula for change of scale property. So what is change of scale property? So change of scale property is given by if Laplace of f of t or function of t is equal to phi of s, that is function of s, then the change of scale property says that Laplace of function of at is equal to 1 by a function of s by a. Now to derive this property, we'll start with the definition of Laplace transform. Now what is the definition of Laplace transform? So here I'll say by the definition of Laplace transform, we have Laplace of function of t is equal to integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t dt. I'll say this as equation number 1. Now as I want to find out Laplace of function of at, I'll say that this my f of t is f of at. So on the right hand side also I'll put it as function of at. So here therefore Laplace of function of at is equal to integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of at dt. So this is by the definition of Laplace transform. Now let's evaluate this integration and let's prove that it is equal to 1 by a phi of s by a. Now for that what we'll do is, here I'll use the integration by substitution method. So here I'll put at as u. So if I put at equal to u, then here I get t as u upon a. And if I'll find the differentiation with respect to u, then here we'll get dt by du is equal to 1 by a constant and derivative of u with respect to u is 1. So therefore this step will become dt equal to 1 by a du. So this is the substitution that we got for dt in terms of u. Now let's find out the limits. So when it is integration with respect to t, we have limits from 0 to infinity. Now we want to convert it into u. So when t is 0, we'll find out what is the value of u. So when t is 0, here we'll substitute that t 0. So a into 0 is 0. So therefore value of u is also 0 when t is equal to 0. Now when t is infinity, then here we'll get infinity into a, that is infinity, it means u is also infinity. So it means the limits are unchanged or limits remains same for u. So now let's substitute this lower and upper limits, the substitution for t and the substitution for dt in the integration. So we will get therefore Laplace of function of at is equal to integration 0 to infinity. Now here we have e raised to minus s into t, but the value of t is u upon a. So here we'll get minus s u by a. So here I'll say e raised to minus s u by a. Next at is u, so here we'll get f of u, and dt is 1 by a du. So f of u into 1 by a du. Now I can take this 1 by a outside since it is a constant, and here we'll get integration 0 to infinity. Now integration is with respect to u, so this s and a are constant. So here I'll say e raised to minus s upon a into u into f of u du. Now, 1 by a as it is, and to get the substitution of this integration, let's again observe the definition of Laplace transform. So, according to definition, here we have e raised to minus st f of t dt, and the Laplace of f of t is given as function of s. So, here I will say that this value is equal to function of s. So, I can say it here, or here I will say that it is equal to function of s. It means whatever is the coefficient of t, you will get function of that variable. So, here we have s as a coefficient of t, hence we are getting the function of s in the answer. So, similarly, if you will observe the current term, then here the coefficient of u is s by a. It means here we are gonna get the function of s by a. So, I got this from the definition of Laplace transform. So, here if you'll observe, then we got the Laplace of function of a t as 1 upon a phi of s by a, which is the change of scale property. Thank you.